For this work, we had to rely on a small comic book in 6 boxes, called Francis. The first step was to find an idea. I wondered how I was going to turn this comic book into a funny and quirky short film. The idea actually came up as a result of a joke with a friend. Why not turn Badger into a big rabbit and his rocket into a giant carrot? With this first idea in mind, I made a storyboard that allowed me to put my ideas down on paper. I then move on to the 2D animatics of my project, which consists in the staging of the storyboard. It allowed me to imagine the timing of my future animated film for the first time. Once the 2D animatic down, I move on the first 3D draft. This 3D animatic allowed me to imagine a more fluid draft closer to what it will finally be produced. Although, it is not yet definitive, it allows to experience the camera movements. This brings us to the next step, which is the search for the scenery and its modeling. I think this step is quite important. I made some research in order to have an idea on what my animation could look like. The question I had to answer first was, what kind of style do I want? Will it be realistic, low poly, stylized or cartoon style? One of my first inspirations was the animated series Skyloo, whose style is particularly fancy, but I didn't want exactly the same thing, so I went further and let my imagination run wild. One thing leading to another, we are getting closer and closer to the final product. This layout stage is an important phase in the film project. The animation isn't perfect yet, but it allows to understand what the character will do at a given moment. The cameras and the timing are already final. Concretely, at this layout stage, we only have to animate since most of the modeling is finished. On the other hand, we're missing one last thing, and it's certainly the most essential and complex part in the creation process of this little film, the rigging. The rigging is therefore the world design part of what will allow us to animate our character. In order to animate it, you have to create controllers. Just like a real skeleton, our character is made out of bones. It's these bones that are going to be animated. A lot of emotions go through the face, so I had to create different expressions of our character. To do this, I used the Blender software to rescale the neutral expression of my character to realize different possible expressions. Of course, many expressions didn't work at first because I was getting some weird distortions. This is where corrective blend shapes come in, which consists of reshaping to expressions that don't work so that it matches perfectly. And here we are at last. After all the different steps, we are finally at the animation itself. Having animated my different parts before, I knew quite well what I wanted to do, but I was missing my references. A great thing to do as an animator is to reproduce by ourselves the scene that we are going to create. It is also in this part that I worked on the particles. For my rocket, I wanted there to be smoke for it to take off. However, I didn't want something realistic, I wanted to stay in a cartoon style. So I simulated the smoke by setting it as I wanted it to be and animated so that it follows the rocket. Once the animation finished, we have to work on the renderings before being able to get our images out. I start my renderings on Mantua, but the result wasn't really clean. With Houdini, each frame needed 5 minutes to process. While on Blender, with the Eevee engine, it only needed 6 seconds per frame, and furthermore, I had the better quality. So, I decided to process my renderings on Blender. So, I released all my Atomic animations from Houdini and imported into Blender. In Blender, I obviously had to put back all the texture, reduce the lighting, and so on. In the end, doing that saved me a lot of time, even if it took more work in first instance. Once all my images were exported from Blender, I moved on to After Effects and Premiere Pro to work on the post-production. It wasn't the longest part of the project because most of my shots were already well sequenced. In After Effects, I only had to superimpose my different layers and do a little water paint for the smoke. In Premiere Pro, I had to do the editing, I choose how my transitions will be, I adjust the colorimetry of some scenes, and obviously edit the sound. In order to make the sound for my animation, I used the Reaper software. For my character's voice, I record my own voice. And I record my sister voice for the computer voice.
Sorry, Francis. I'm afraid I can't do that.
For the sound, I first start with the ambient sound. I then added the sound of my character footsteps. Then his voice. Then the sound effects. And finally, the music. With this little film, I also want to pay tribute to one of the greatest classics of the cinema in the category of space, which is obviously 2001 A Space Odyssey. I added various little wings to the film, starting with Chor's music, which is the theme of the film. The poster in the control room, the AL 9000 Mac, the illuminated floor, or AL 9000 itself as a computer at the end of my short film.
And so does orchestra end. Don't hesitate to have a look at the book which contains some other works. Thank you to follow me in my process, and I hope you enjoyed it. Goodbye.